Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to start our second chapter of history, and our chapter name is Rioting in City Life. As you know, first chapter is deleted from our syllabus for this session. So in second chapter, we are going to discuss some of the earlier cities. One of them is Mesopotamian, present Iraq. So we all know that cities basically arise around the temples. In this way, we can say people who live around their cities were might be king, queen, laborers, craftsmen, and scribes. All these evidence we got to know from the collection of archaeologist department. In this way, some more facts in a deep manner we will read in this chapter, and how it possible without invention of writing these cities arise in the world. Now, Mesopotamian civilization. Different names used for the same civilization. Mesopotamian civilization. Mesopotamian civilization, the name Mesopotamia is derived from the Greek word mesos. Mesos means middle and potamos means river. So Mesopotamia means the land between two rivers. And rivers name are Euphrates and Tigris. Now Sumerian civilization. Sumerian civilization, the first known language of Mesopotamia was Sumerian. That is why this civilization is otherwise called as Sumerian civilization. And now third is Babylonian civilization. Babylon civilization after 2000 BC, when Babylon become an important city of this civilization, is called as Babylonian civilization. Now fourth is Akkadian civilization. Akkadian civilization after 2400 BC, when Akkadian speakers arrived and established their rule in the southern part of Mesopotamia, it was called as Akkadian civilization. Now fifth is Usurian civilization. When Usurians speakers arrived and established their rule in the southern part of Mesopotamia, it was called as Usurian civilization. Now, features of Mesopotamian civilization. Mesopotamian civilization known for its prosperity, city life, and rich literature. It's mathematics and astronomy, and Mesopotamia's writing system and the literature spread to the eastern Mediterranean, northern Syria, and Turkey also. So these are the features of Mesopotamian civilization. Now, sources to understand Mesopotamian civilization. We study hundreds of Mesopotamian buildings, statues, ornaments, graves, tools, and seals as a sources, and there are thousands of writing documents as wells to study Mesopotamian civilization. So these are the sources of Mesopotamian civilization. Now, Mesopotamian and its geography. Mesopotamian and its geography. We will discuss. Mesopotamia is a land of diverse environments. In the northeast lies green and undulating plains, gradually rising the trees covered mountain range with clear streams and wildflower with enough rainfall to grow crops. And now second is in the north. In the north, there is a stretch of upland called a steppe, where animals herding offers people a better livelihood than agriculture. And after winter rains, sheep and goats feed on the grasses and low shrubs that grow there. And now third is in the east. In the east, tributaries of the Tigris provide routes of communication into the mountains of Iran. And now fourth is in the south. In the south, south is a desert. And this is where the first cities and writing emerged. The desert could support cities because the rivers Euphrates and Tigris which arise in the northern mountains carry loads of silt, and when the when they flood or when the rivers or sorry when the water is let out in the field, the fertile silt is deposited there. And now fifth is agriculture and animals. Agriculture and animals, not only in agriculture, Mesopotamian sheep and goats that graze means the steppe, the northern eastern plains and the mountain slopes produced meat, milk and wool in means on a large scale. And further, fish was available in rivers, and date palms give fruits in summer. So so it was means geographical features of Mesopotamia. Now significance of urbanism in Mesopotamia we are going to discuss. First point is urban centers involves in various economic activities such as food production, trade, manufactures and services. City people thus cease to be self-sufficient and depend on the products or services of other people. There is continuous interaction among them. Now second point is for intents, the carver of a stone seal requires bronze tools, that is means he himself cannot make, or colored stones for the seals that he does not know where to get, and he depends on other for his needs. The division of labors is a mark of urban life. Now third point is there is a there must be a social organization in cities. Fuel, metal, various stones, wood, etc. come from many different places from the city manufacturers, and thus organized trade, storage and deliveries of grains or other food items from the village to the cities were controlled and supervised by the rulers. So these are the means it was the significance of urbanism in Mesopotamia. Hope it is clear to all. Thank you so much.